Hello crafters, I'm Flavia and today's video is all about camper shaped note cards. It was very easy to make this type of note card and I will have lots of examples for you today. These note cards can go inside A2 size envelopes and can be kept on display. I had a lot of fun creating these note cards, especially because I got to combine die sets from different companies to create different campers. And I also got to use my scraps of patterned paper. To create these camper-shaped note cards, I will be using this Honeybee Stamps Camp Trailer die set. I have had this die set for about a year now, and I love creating with this set. Honeybee Stamps also has this wild and free stamp set with sentiments that are just perfect for those who like camping. Since I like having the option to die cut my sentiments, I also purchased the coordinating die set for the stamp set. If you like this set and are interested in purchasing it, know that the wild and free set will be retiring soon. To cut out the note cards in the shape of a camper, I will place this large metal plate on top of an A2 size top folding note card. I will offset this metal plate just a little bit on the side where I folded this note card. This A2 size note card that I'm using is made out of lightweight cardstock, so it was very easy for the metal plate to cut through the two layers of cardstock. If you're using heavyweight cardstock, just make sure that you run it through your die cut machine twice and maybe three times so it cuts through both layers. So this is how we make the camper shaped note card. Now I can go ahead and start cutting all of the other pieces to make my camp trailer. I cut another camper piece out of black cardstock and I will adhere it to the front before adding all of the other small die cut pieces. Because these metal plates are small, I can cut many pieces at once, which is great. Since I have a lot of scraps of patterned paper, I will be using that for most of my campers. I will also be using die sets from different companies to cut out other elements such as birds, butterflies, and plants to create different campers. The metal dies to cut out the steps and the awnings for this trailer also left markings on the cardstock indicating where we should fold them. And now that I have my camper ready, I will start working on the sentiment for this note card. Since I am still not sure which one of the sentiments I will be using and I like them all, I will actually stamp all of the sentiments now so I have leftovers for the next time I make more note cards. Usually when I buy a sentiment stamp set with lots of sentiments that I know I will be using, instead of removing each stamp from this clear acetate sheet and stamp one at a time, I just tape the whole acetate sheet on my Misty stamping tool. And by stamping all of these sentiments without removing them from the packaging, we can be sure that they will all be perfectly spaced. Having sentiments ready to go is a great time saver. To stamp my sentiments, I will be using Autoneal Obsidian Pigment Ink. This is a rich black ink color and I will top it with clear embossing powder. Then I will use my heating gun to melt the powder and all of the sentiments will be glossy, which I like. Once that's done, I can go ahead and die cut my sentiments. Here is a closer look at some of them and I love this one that says, "Life is better in flip-flops." But for this black and white camper, I actually chose the sentiment, "You make life one big adventure." And to add some dimension to this die-cut sentiment, I actually cut a few more pieces using the coordinating die for the sentiment so I could stack them and make it stand out more. If you do not like adding dimension to your note cards, you can definitely skip this step. And here is a closer look so you can see the difference between my stacked die cuts and another die cut sentiment with only one layer. It really is just a matter of preference, but if you like adding dimension to your projects, using scraps of cardstock instead of foam is a great way to use up your leftover pieces. And as a final touch, I will add a planter by the door. To cut out this planter, I use an old die set by Spellbinders. The process was exactly the same for all of the other note cards that I made. However, I did add different die-cut elements using sets from other companies, such as this cute little birdie that I die-cut using the Spellbinder Sweet Birds on a Branch die set. I like this set so much that I always have lots of these birds ready to go. I really enjoy combining die sets from different companies to create new scenes. That is a great way to maximize our stamps and die sets. For this note card, I chose the sentiment "Home is where we park it." And I also stacked some layers for dimension, like I did with the previous camper. Usually when I get a new set with elements that I know I will be using a lot, such as hearts, flowers, birds, butterflies, and stars, I like to have them always handy for when I'm making a note card, so I do not have to keep on stopping all of the time to die cut them. So once in a while, I make the time to sit down and cut out lots of pieces at once. So all of these extra die cut pieces that I added to this campus, I already had ready to go. I find that by having die cut pieces ready, saves me a lot of time when I'm making a note card. So I will show you now all of the campus that I was able to make today, along with the matching envelope. For this black and white camper, I stamped a happy birthday sentiment on the flap of the envelope using silver embossing powder. And as you can see, the recipient will be able to keep this camper on display if he wants to. To add some sparkle to the wings of this bird, I went over it with my Spectrum Noir shimmer pen and I added some gloss to the flower pot by applying Ranger Glossy Accents. To make most of these envelopes match the note card, I simply added a cardstock strip using that same cardstock for the camper. And since I wasn't so sure on how I was supposed to adhere the frame for the door and the window, for the note card on the right, I placed the frame on top, and for the note card on the left, I placed the frame under the door and the window. And I think they both look great. This butterfly, by the way, is also from another die set by Spellbinders named Butterfly Bliss Garden Shutters. This is my favorite die sets for cutting butterflies, and I always have lots of these butterflies ready to go. I hope you enjoyed this video and felt inspired. Thank you so much for spending this time with me, and I hope you can find the time to get creative. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. And remember, you can always visit my blog for pictures and more information on these note cards. Take care and have a wonderful week.